Towards the end of year 2020, Jammu and Kashmir witnessed the first electoral process in the form of DDC elections after the erstwhile state lost its special status on August 5, 2019. Through an amendment to the Panchayati Raj Act, DDC was brought in an attempt to revive the defunct systems of governance such as Panchayati Raj and enable all the three tiers of the same.
What DDC elections actually mean is that you have an intermediate level of governance. While you have panchayats at the ground, and then you have a state assembly at the top, and in the middle you have an elected body, that is the DDC. Earlier we used to have the District Planning and Development Board, which actually was not an elected body. You had no representative from the ground into that body, which actually is for the preparing and implementing the development plans for the district, and it used to be headed by Chief Minister and later by some ministers, a cabinet minister. Now what's going to happen is that you will have these 14 members from the district who will be part of that district plan making and implementation, and you will have an additional DC or some functionary who will be the chairman of this body. But then you will have elected representatives from each district who will formulate the district plans and who will later on look after also the implementation of those plans, the central schemes, look after the working of panchayats, district, within the district. So it's a sort of an intermediate level of, in this governance structure, an intermediate level that's now elected by the people, which was earlier missing. Although this provision was very much there in the, Jammu and Kashmir Panchayat Raj Act 1989, but it was not implemented. So now it is implemented on the ground.
Although these elections came to be seen as a kickstart to the democratic process in Jammu and Kashmir, but at the same time, the abrupt decision to conduct these polls, besides the long overdue assembly elections, raised questions over its motives.
They just wanted to conduct elections, and they were under this impression that National Conference and PAGD will not contest and we will win hands down. So they got the shock of their life when we decided that we would also contest these elections.
One cannot go, have a clear idea about this understanding, but one can just guess. Maybe BJP was trying to test the ground. Maybe they were trying to see how the political parties will react to it, how people will react to it. Yes, it has given an opening to the regional political parties, because post abrogation they were left with no narrative and there was complete disconnect. It was also that to give an idea that democracy has been restored, and maybe also, as now statements are coming, to put it that this is something as post abrogation politics has been restored, normalcy has been restored.
With an overall of 51% voter turnout in the UT, 34% voted in the Kashmir region. While BJP hails the participation in the polls as the restoration of the faith of Kashmiris in democracy and a validation to August 5 decision, PAGD members call it a step towards retaining what was lost.
तो ये जो बढ़ चढ़ करके लोगों ने उत्साहित होकर के इसमें भाग लिया है, विशेषकर कश्मीर घाटी में, जहाँ पर के पिछले 30-35 वर्षों से कोई भी चुनाव आप देख लीजिए 5-10% से ज़्यादा वोटर टर्नआउट नहीं रहता था, क्योंकि लोग मायूस हो चुके थे। उन्हें लगता था कि वही चेहरे बार बार, वही वंशवाद, वही परिवार और वही सदस्य का, चाहे वो विधानसभा का चुनाव हो, कभी संसद का हो, लेकिन जो उनके अपने बीच में से निकल कर के प्रतिनिधि आने चाहिए थे उसका उन्हें अवसर नहीं मिल रहा था। तो जो उनकी एस्पिरेशन है, जो उनकी डेमोक्रेटिक एस्पिरेशन और जो उनकी प्रजातांत्रिक आकांक्षाएं हैं, उनको पहली बार एक अवसर मिला है, और वो जो तमन्ना जमहूरियत के 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 प्रति जो शायद कहीं झुलस गई थी, उसने फिर से एक अगड़ाई ली है। मैं तो इसको इस तरह से देखूंगा।
दिस वॉज एन अपॉर्चुन मोमेंट वेयर वी कुड यूज अ डेमोक्रेटिक exercise a system, a democratic system, and we could send out a clear message. It's not that people would come out on roads and throw stones or any other mean. It's a very clear cut, a democratic means of saying, a very peaceful means of saying, no, we have not accepted August 5 decision. The another reason was that this space is too important and too sacred for all of us to have been let it go like that. So that was our second reason to actually jump into the fray and contest these elections.
Experts on the other hand see it otherwise.
Some people are trying to convince us, they're trying to say that the people, by taking part in the democratic process, they have endorsed the abrogation of Article 37, they have supported it by their conduct, which is not true. So the answer to that is that we have had elections since mid-90s. We had an election in 1989 for the Indian Parliament, and there was total boycott, almost total boycott. But then in mid-90s, there was an election to the Assembly, and I saw with my own eyes how people were, how the paramilitary, they knocked on the doors of people and herded them to police station, polling booths. There was coercive voting. That was another phase. But after that, I also saw willing participation of people in large numbers. But then we have to see one thing. This participation of people in elections, I have talked to people, the voters, stood in queues outside the polling booths. They had their own reasons. For instance, a few voters told me once that they wanted their own government in the state, which would act as a buffer between the people and the security forces. And they needed their own administration for the governance of their day-to-day affairs. So they had their own preferences, priorities. But one, this 2008, whatever happened in 2008 and after, that illustrates the point. First, we had the land row, land agitation here, and which lasted, that was summer unrest first. People in their tens of thousands took to the streets. And same year, in perhaps November, we had elections. I remember when I saw a couple of hundred people outside a polling booth, I thought they had been forcibly brought to the booth. But then they told me they had come of their own volition. So there was no compulsion, no coercion. And the same people again, they were the people who were taking to the streets. We had people in large numbers marching towards the LOC. If you remember, they marched to Uri, they wanted to cross the line of control. That was part of the 2008 agitation. Then the same year we had elections, and people participated in those elections in large numbers. And in 2009, we had another summer unrest, and 2010, we had yet another summer unrest. So who were the people who participated in those protests? And who were the people? It was the same people. And then we had elections in 2014. Within 2 years of those elections, we had a massive public protests after the death of Burhan Wani. So the point I want to make is that the participation of people in the elections, in the democratic process, does not signify anything as for the people's preferences vis-a-vis the Kashmir question are concerned. They are the people who vote, and they are the people who participate in demonstrations against the Indian rule.
The results of the maiden District Development Council elections were followed by an ironical situation in which the major stakeholders of the poll, including People's Alliance for Gupkar Declaration, Bharatiya Janata Party, and many independents, celebrated the results and savoured a victory in one way or the other. But experts are critical of the celebration. While they think BJP has failed to achieve any major gains in Kashmir, they also believe that the victory of the Gupkar Alliance has little meaning and could be ephemeral.
One important thing is that BJP failed to get people's endorsement for its own narrative. They have been making a big thing out of this. They have been celebrating rather that they have opened an account in Kashmir Valley, 3 seats. But they forget that they have not put up the kind of performance they could have in Jammu. Jammu has been a stronghold, first of the Congress Party, then of the BJP. And Jammu people in Jammu, ordinary people in Jammu, supported the abrogation of Article 3. But now there is resentment because there are fears in the minds of people that their land will be snatched. So whatever, so the BJP, they didn't vote as overwhelmingly for the BJP as they were expected. So BJP has suffered a setback in Jammu region as well. And the Gupkar alliance has won a sizable number of seats. But that does not mean Gupkar alliance has every reason to celebrate, to be happy. But they are still, I would say, irrelevant to the situation. They have not become popular. They have been voted. People have voted for the Gupkar alliance, no doubt. But that doesn't mean they will be calling the shots. They have to redefine their own. They have to find a role for themselves. This time they found a plank, they found a slogan, which they went to the people. Next time, what will they do? Will they convince the people that they are able to have this special status restored? People have been wondering, they have been asking this question. This time, people could be mobilized because of this anti-BJP sentiment. That is a strong sentiment in Kashmir Valley, anti-BJP sentiment. You could mobilize, galvanize them on that issue. But beyond that, I don't think the Gupkar alliance has that much popularity or that much influence. Had that been so, we have another one important thing happening here. A large number of independents winning the elections. Why? At whose expense? These seats could have gone to any party in the Gupkar alliance. But independents have managed. This is a setback to the Gupkar alliance.
Another reason why DDC polls are less significant politically than being projected is the limited powers of the DDC candidates. Ashraf explains how.
The most important aspect of this that one has to realize is that these elections have a very limited meaning, especially as far as their powers and what they are meant for. Now, these elections and the elected representatives have a very given mandate. That's formulation. They are part of the formulation of the plan. Their jurisdiction is district. They cannot go beyond that district. And it is like implementing the schemes or making the plans and then looking after the implementation of those plans. So there is no question about politics in this. So one should not assume or in a way, expect too much from these elections and that this is going to change some narrative or this is going to change the politics of the state. It's not going to be constituted an assembly. They are not going to come together as a one group. Every individual who has been elected is mandated within his jurisdiction. And the mandate is very much economic rather than political in that sense.
The results are out and the verdict is somewhat on the expected lines. Despite putting a poor show in polls in comparison to PAGD, BJP is still expected to make gains out of these elections in national politics. However, the roadmap of PAGD seems unclear.
The BJP has played a gamble, huge gamble. BJP stands to gain whatever has been done in Kashmir. BJP stands. It's not that they will gain or lose in J&K. No, that's not material for any. That's immaterial for BJP, for Congress, for any party. But they use it in the Indian politics, electoral politics. They use Kashmir as a pawn on the political chessboard of India. They go to Bihar, look, we have revoked the Article 370, so vote for us. Even in the US, Narendra Modi as Prime Minister, he talked of this abrogation of Article 370.
the way these DC elections have turned out. Now it's very interesting to see whether assembly elections or whether the restoration of state or without state in the Union Territory, because it is a Union Territory with assembly, whether those elections are actually held or held very soon, or maybe it could delay their decision. Maybe it did not, if this has not gone as BJP would have predicted or New Delhi would have predicted, then certainly we will see a delay in those elections, maybe not very soon. But if there's a real sense of that, whatever the results we actually wanted the political process to start, then one should see a hurry in New Delhi going for the elections. And how people will react in those state assembly elections? Well, if DDC is some clue to that, then obviously it will again be repeated. It will not be something different. And this was something that was very predictable, on predicted lines, that you may have again. And also it will be very interesting to see that whether into those elections the alliance will stay. And it will be very interesting, in fact, to see that now on where does this alliance head.